And as believers in the resurrection, we are defined by our hope in that a suffering Messiah indeed has been raised from the dead. And this wonderful knowledge of faith and trust is most evidently displayed in four of the most famous post-Easter stories in the New Testament. The story of the gardener, of the cook, of the stranger, and the housebreaker. All speak at moments of complete disarray, disillusionment, and despair. All four touch on God's unexpected ways that are thrust into the lives of people. You already know the stories. The story of the gardener, for example. When the gardener calls the weeping woman in the garden, he calls her by her first name, Mary. She turns, and out of her grief, she recognizes the Lord. Gone to mourn for the dead, she is now with the living God. Having thought that she was talking to the gardener, she wants a plea to her Lord. And so the joke is on Mary. In our second story, we have those dejected disciples and apostles who have gone fishing soon after Jesus' gruesome death for lack of something to do. They put their nets into the sea with despair and disillusionment because they had just seen their master and friend horribly crucified. But then they begin to sniff something in the air. They smell something. On the lakes of the shore where they're fishing, they make out that someone is cooking fish. And as the boats draw nearer to the shore, they are starting to make out who this person is. And John, the younger of the 12, and the one with the keen insight, explains to Peter, "It is the Lord." Think of that. An outdoor barbecue breakfast that God is giving unexpectedly to his dear and closest friends who would never have expected it. With a lost appetite for life, they were now filled with the nourishment of God's unexpected surprise and presence in their lives. And so the joke was on them. In that wonderful gospel scene that we will read in 2 weeks' time, we have two young dejected apostles traveling to a city called Emmaus. Again, they are totally despondent on the day's events of Jesus' missing body. And so a stranger joins them. He speaks to them. He excites them. He eats with them. He breaks bread with them. And then they recognize who he is. Their hearts were broken. But the one who breaks bread, not hearts, simply smiles and disappears in just a moment. And the joke is on them. And finally, in that most famous account, where scripture tells that the disciples were locked in an upper room for fear of the establishment, Jesus pops in the room and surprises them. Now I know scripture says that his first words were, "Peace be with you." But I think that Jesus' first words to his friends was, "Gotcha, man!" So startled were they that this Jesus came through God's voice, so startled that they saw his body and blood and markings on his body, that they were so stubbornly astounded. They probably couldn't catch their breath. They were probably laughing and crying at the same time, much like you and I would do. And so my friends, all these stories, all these jokes, all these understanding wonderful tales about the resurrection and the life are our Easter Sunday life. Today tells us of a stranger as the stranger and as the housebreaker, who lifts us up, turns our despair into sorrow, gives us new beginnings and our old disappointments, turns around death into life, and makes us laugh